Okay, so we started reading Ponies on Friday. We're going to finish that book today, like I said we were going to. And we stopped on page 16 is where we got to start reading from. Some ponies have white patches of hair. These are called markings. A pony's feet can have a sock or a stocking. I didn't know that about ponies. So here is a sock. So the white markings are just on the bottom of their feet. And here's a stocking, which is another word for sock or a type of sock. And on ponies, for it to be called a stocking, the white marking has to go all the way up their leg, kind of to where their knee is. A pony's head can have a blaze, a star, a snip, or a stripe. So if the pony's head has white markings on it, it can have a blaze. And if you look, that is like all the way up to its eyes, like its whole nose is white. A star is just a little white spot on its forehead, I guess right there, or maybe it's a bigger mark. A snip is a smaller mark. Sorry, I was reading the label wrong. And then a sprite is one that goes all up to its nose, or a stripe, not a sprite. It goes all the way up to its nose, but it's just like a stripe, like what it says, not a blaze like this one. So a star is a little bit bigger than a snip. A snip is just a small little spot. Wild ponies. There are still wild ponies today. A herd of wild ponies lives in Maryland and Virginia, USA. They are called Chincoteague and Assateague ponies. Oh, thank God. See, I read that, but I didn't notice it down here. It tells me how to pronounce it because I was trying to figure it out, but now I'll know how to pronounce it the right way. This is some pronunciation. Can you say that big word, pronunciation? So it tells you how to say it. So it's actually called a Chincoteague pony or Assateague pony. So I said the second one right, just it's a Chincoteague, not a Chincoteague. Another pony word they're telling us right here is herd. A large group of animals that live together is called a herd. So the ponies live in herds, apparently. The herd has been around for more than 500 years. Wow. That's a long time. Humans don't live that long. We're lucky if we live about 80 years. So this particular herd, not that the ponies have lived this long, but this herd of ponies. So it's like the same family over and over. This herd has been around for 500 years. That's a lot of years. Wild ponies are not given food or shelter. They run free. So these ponies don't live on a farm or in a barn. They're wild, so they get to run free all on their own. Shelter, a safe place that gives protection from bad weather. So your house is a shelter, or your garage, or your car can be considered a shelter. Ponies in the past. Ponies in the past were used for work. Ponies pulled carriages around town. They carried people and things. Ponies also worked on farms and in the mountains and in coal mines. So it's showing you a picture of ponies pulling people. If you go to Greenfield Village, you can take a pony carriage ride, not a pony ride. You can take a carriage ride where some horses pull you. I don't think they're ponies. And then it shows a pony that was working in a coal mine. So coal mines are where they go down into the earth like a big cave. And they bring out coal that we use for energy. But this label says coal mine pony. And this label here says pony drawn carriage. Ponies today. Ponies today are still used for work, but mostly people ride and enjoy them. People ride ponies in shows and races. They ride ponies on trails. They even ride them on vacation. So it's showing you some pictures. There's somebody riding a pony. There's somebody who, it looks like they rode in a competition like this and got some sort of a ribbon award. And then there's some people on vacation riding ponies. Wow, they got like backpacks and everything. Those ponies can carry a lot of weight. Caring for a pony. So it's going to tell us how to care for a pony on page 26. Ponies make great pets, but they are a lot of work, like any pet. Pets are a lot of work. Every day, a pony needs fresh food and water, exercise, brushing, and cleaning. So kind of like you. You need food and water every day. You need to have your hair brushed if you have a lot of hair. And you need to get some exercise, like playing or going outside. So I see there they're doing something with the horse's hoof. And on page 28, they're going to tell us about riding. The work is done, now it's time to ride. You will need special clothes. The clothes protect you and the pony. So the labels show me you need a riding helmet, riding pants called joppers. I think these help protect your legs from getting a rash on the inside. Gloves and riding boots. Gloves are probably so you don't get blisters, and riding boots are so that your feet stay safe. And if you notice, it has a pronunciation thing for joppers. But Miss Marlene already knew how to say that word. Then, after you have all those things on, you can enjoy your pony ride. On page 30, it says, what in the world? So it's asking us a question. These pictures show close-up views of pony things. So it says we're going to try to figure out what's in the pictures. Oh. So this pony marking rhymes with gaze. I think it's blaze. What do you think? Blaze, gaze, those rhyme. And we read about that, how if it's like a big marking on their nose, like almost the whole nose, then it's a blaze. And then this picture says a pony rider sits here. And you can hear my dog whining at me. She wants attention. And then a baby pony is called this for the first year. Do you remember what a baby pony was called? It rhymes with goal. Foal. And then it says you need to wear this when you ride, a helmet to protect your head, because if you fall off, it's gonna hurt. And this pony marking rhymes with car. What could rhyme with star? Do you remember what we read about? I just said the answer. Miss Marlene's silly. Car, star, it's a star. And then it tells us about the words we learned, breed. A group of animals that have similar features and look alike, that's a breed. So ponies is a breed of horses. A herd is a large group of ponies that live together. A mare is a female horse. And shelter is a safe place that gives you protection from bad weather. And then, of course, it shows us some other books we can read that are like this one. The end. I'll see you tomorrow for Read Alouds.